In the midst of the Cold War's geopolitical tension, the United States sought innovative means to maintain military superiority. Enter the Davy Crockett Weapon System, a revolutionary fusion of nuclear capability and battlefield mobility. Named in honor of the legendary frontiersman Davy Crockett, this system represented a paradigm shift in nuclear warfare strategy. Rather than relying solely on massive strategic bombs, the Davy Crockett offered a compact, portable nuclear option tailored for tactical engagements. Developed in the late 1950s and deployed throughout the early 1960s, the Davy Crockett came in two main variants, the M28 and the M29. Production of the Davy Crockett began at Picatinny Arsenal following the approval of the design on August 15, 1958. There was approval for funding of 6,247 to be manufactured, but a total of 2,100 were actually made. The M28 variant was designed to be operated by a two-man crew. It consisted of a lightweight launcher weighing approximately 74 pounds or 34 kilograms, and a nuclear warhead with a yield ranging from 10 to 20 tons of TNT. The M28 launcher was also equipped with a 20mm spotting rifle, a single-shot weapon that fired depleted uranium rounds using a high-low system. These rounds flew a similar trajectory to the nuclear projectiles and produced white smoke when they landed, helping determine the range. The Davy Crockett was fired remotely using a mechanically operated detonator at the end of 22 meters or 72 feet of detonating cord led to the propellant charge. The M388 nuclear projectile was attached to a titanium piston by means of a bayonet mount. When fired, the piston was blown out of the tube by the detonating propellant. The piston was hollow and filled with high-pressure gas. From the explosion, this pressure broke shear pins that connected the piston to the nuclear projectile, detaching it after a few meters of flight. The piston would hit the ground several hundred meters in front of the weapon while the projectile continued to the target. The Davy Crockett contained a W54 Mod 2 nuclear warhead. It was a very compact, pure fission device weighing 50.9 pounds or 23.1 kilograms, and when packed in the M38-8 round, it weighed 76 pounds or 34 kilograms. Controls on the projectile included a two-position height of burst switch that could be set to 2 feet and 40 feet air burst, a safety switch with a safe and arm position, and a time-setting dial that allowed a time delay between 1 and 50 seconds before the fuse was armed. If the time delay was greater than the time of flight, the weapon would hit the ground before it armed and not detonate. The crew typically consisted of 3 to 5 soldiers, including a gunner, an assistant gunner, and ammunition handlers. Specialized training programs were developed to ensure proficiency in handling and operating the Davy Crockett system safely and effectively. The weapon was made from lightweight metals. The tripod was aluminum, the barrel was titanium, and it was possible to break the smaller M28 weapon into 3 loads that could be carried by the crew, with the other 2 crew carrying 2 radios and accessories. The weight of the M28 launcher was 185 pounds or 84 kilograms, while the bigger M29 weighed 440 pounds or 200 kilograms. The M28 variant was intended for close range engagements, with a maximum effective range of about 1.25 miles or 2 kilometers. Its portability made it suitable for use by infantry units, providing them with a powerful deterrent against enemy forces. The limited firing range was due to the combination of poor aerodynamics of the watermelon with fins, while some soldiers also referred to the warhead as the atomic watermelon. The M29 variant, on the other hand, was a vehicle-mounted system, designed to be mounted on lightweight vehicles such as the M151 Jeep and the M113 Armored Personnel Carrier. This allowed for greater mobility and flexibility on the battlefield. The shell's greatest effect would have been its extreme prompt neutron radiation, which would have killed most of the enemy troops inside that circle within minutes. Its blast would do very little damage, if any, to the enemy tracked vehicles. Troops further away would have died within hours, days, and less than 2 weeks, depending on their range from the point of burst and the thickness of their protection. Both recoilless guns proved to have good accuracy in testing, most training shots landing within 10 feet of the point of aim and circular air probability of under 50 meters, with a 100% instant casualty radius in excess of 160 meters. Deployment of the Davy Crockett system required careful planning and coordination. Crew members would scout out potential firing positions, taking into account factors such as terrain, enemy locations, and the safety of friendly forces. While the Davy Crockett was never deployed in actual combat, its presence served as a powerful deterrent, shaping the strategic calculus of the Cold War era. The Davy Crockett and its variants remain a symbol of the technological ambition and ethical dilemmas of the Cold War era. While they provided infantry units an unprecedented firepower, their deployment raised serious concerns about the risks of nuclear warfare and the consequences of wielding such power on the battlefield.